Hi there, I am Amedeo Sapia and I'm going to present SwitchML, Scaling Distributed Machine Learning Within Network Aggregation. Modern machine learning solutions are so successful because they can build increasingly sophisticated models to accurately represent real-world problems. And as models become more complex, they require training on increasingly larger datasets. This increase in size and complexity made distributed training very common. With distributed training, large-scale clusters use hundreds of nodes to run training jobs, and each node can be equipped with multiple hardware accelerators. Nevertheless, a training job can still take many hours, days, or even weeks. So, why does this happen? Well, in theory, distributed training wants to use combined resources across multiple nodes in an efficient way. But in reality, for some workloads, there are significant synchronization overheads. As an example, we have measured the amount of time spent for communication during training of different models on an 8-server testbed. And for some models, we can see that a large amount of time is spent in communication. So we asked ourselves, can we reduce the overhead of communication? Maybe the network itself can become the machine learning accelerator. Let's first take a look at how distributed machine learning works, assuming data parallel mode. In data parallel mode, the training dataset is divided among all the workers, and each worker keeps a local copy of the current model. During one iteration of the training job, each worker goes through a subset of its own dataset. The result of this computation is a model update, one or more large vectors that represent the changes that must be applied to the model parameters to reach a higher accuracy. Now, before the next iteration, the workers need to share the result of their work. So they exchange and merge together, or aggregate, these updates. And the result is applied to their local models. In this way, they can start the next iteration using a model that is most probably better than the single local models they used in the previous iteration. And this process goes on and on for many iterations. And since these updates can be made of very large vectors of hundreds of megabytes or even gigabytes, the communication time becomes a significant portion of the iteration time. And as a result, efficient use of the network becomes very important. This process requires a very intensive communication in a whole-to-whole fashion, and this leads to a significant use of the network. How is this communication step performed today? There are two ways to deal with this problem that are very common today. One is the use of parameter servers, and the other one is to use collective operations, like ring or reduce. In both cases, additional network resources and computation cycles are spent to perform this operation, leading to either an increase of the cost of the infrastructure or larger communication time. So since distributed machine learning scales poorly due to communication costs, we thought, maybe network devices can help. And so we considered programmable data planes, which are new networking ASICs that can process terabits of traffic per second, while also providing significant flexibility on how the traffic must be processed. Thanks to programmable data planes, SwitchML can aggregate model updates directly inside the network, making the network the new machine learning accelerator. But there are some challenges to this approach. Since programmable ASICs need to process traffic at a very high speed, they have only a few nanoseconds to process a single packet. So they cannot perform a large amount of computation and can use only costly and scarce in-chip memory. Moreover, these chips often do not provide floating point units because they are not usually needed by common network protocols. But floating points at multiple levels of precision are common in machine learning training. We also need to consider that packet losses can happen. To deal with these challenges, SwitchML is designed with a combined switch host architecture to share the work between hosts and switches, a pool-based streaming aggregation to deal with the limited memory of networking ASICs, a block-based quantization approach to deal with missing floating points units, a failure recovery protocol to deal with packet losses, and an in-switch RDMA implementation to reach line rate processing even at 100 gigabit per second. First, let's take a look at how streaming aggregation works. Here we assume that the workers need to share updates that are way larger than the amount of memory available in the switching ASIC. SwitchML divides the memory in the switch in a pool of slots, where one slot stores the amount of data carried by a single packet. At the beginning of the aggregation task, the worker sends as many packets as the amount of slots available for the job, which can be negotiated beforehand. When the switch receives a packet from a worker, it aggregates the data in the packet with the stored data for the same slot and stores the result. Once all the workers have sent their contribution to a slot, the switch sends the final result back to the workers. And this is considered a signal that there are free slots in the switch that can be reused for the new portion of the updates. This self-clocking mechanism ensures that no data is lost and that at the end of all the workers have the same accurate result. Having multiple outstanding packets ensures that the network is used efficiently and line rate can be reached even for faster networks. Please check the paper for a detailed description of our fault tolerance mechanism needed to deal with packet losses. To deal with the limited computational capabilities of programmable ASICs, SwitchML uses a combined switch host architecture, where the work is appropriately split between workers and switches. The workers are in charge of driving the protocol, perform quantization to convert floating points to fixed point values, and to address failures, while the switch performs fixed point aggregation. To reach high accuracy of the result, SwitchML uses a block quantization approach. With this approach, a round of aggregation is performing both fixed point aggregation and the computation of the best scaling factors to use for the quantization of the next blocks of elements. The scaling factors are chosen to maximize accuracy while avoiding overflow in the switch. We experimented with a range of models, and we saw that this block-based quantization approach allows training to similar accuracy in a similar number of iterations as an unquantized network. In this slide, I'm showing training of ResNet, but I refer you to the paper for an extensive evaluation of multiple models. Given the limited amount of computational resources, there is a limit to the number of elements that a switch can process. We implemented SwitchML on an Intel Tofino switch, which implements a PISA architecture. This switching ASIC has four pipelines to process up to 6.5 terabits per second. We found that each pipeline can process in one pass 256 bytes of payload per packet, and given framing overhead, this results in a network efficiency of 75.7%. SwitchML implements also a second strategy based on chaining the pipelines together to process 1,024 bytes of payloads per packet, which provides a 92.6% network efficiency, which is the maximum efficiency possible with RDMA on Ethernet without using jumbo frames. Given the time limitation, I will only show a small part of our evaluation of SwitchML, but I invite you to look at the paper for an extensive evaluation. We implemented SwitchML as a switch program written in P4, and an endosed library providing a familiar or reduced API. We implemented two versions of this library, one using UDP and DPDK, and the other one using RDMA. We integrated this library with common machine learning frameworks such as PyTorch and TensorFlow through Oracle. We evaluated SwitchML using standard machine learning benchmarks to measure training speedup and micro benchmarks to measure pure aggregation performance. We measured the speedup that SwitchML provides when training different models on an 8 nodes and 8 GPUs testbed compared to Nicol RDMA, which is the framework commonly used for these workloads. Here I'm showing results on a 100 gigabit per second network, but the speedups are even larger with slower networks. On the left, you can see that SwitchML can provide speedups between 1.13x to 2.27x, depending on the model, since different models have a different computation to communication ratio. In these experiments, we are using UDP and DPDK, and we expect to get even better performance with RDMA. We also expect even larger improvements with faster GPUs. We simulated training with a 10 times faster GPU, and we have seen that for most models, the reduction in computation time leads to even higher speedups. We also wanted to measure how SwitchML scales with the number of workers. we performed a micro-benchmark experiment with 4, 8, and 16 workers. Here, I'm showing as a metric the number of aggregated elements per second, and we saw that switch ML performance does not depend on the number of workers, differently from the already used approaches such as ECO. To summarize, switch ML performs in-network aggregation to synchronize model parameters updates, reducing both traffic volume and latency. We observed speedups up to 5.5x over Nicol TCP and 2.3x over Nicol RDMA with real-world benchmarks, and showed that with SwitchML, aggregation time does not depend on the number of workers. So it is more beneficial with larger testnets. We are sharing the SwitchML implementation as an open source project under the P4Apps working group of p4.org, and we invite everyone to use it and contribute. Thank you for listening.